Hey, I just want to say before we start this first song that I am so very, very grateful to NBRC and to Mary for letting us do this. It's kind of like the highlight of my week when I get to come and sing for you guys. So this is not something, it's something I've always wanted to do in my life. I never did this until I was a client here and then got involved with this. So thank you, everyone. And thank you, Mary, for allowing us to be up here and sing for you guys.
Shine bright like a diamond. Funny lights in a beautiful scene. I choose to be happy. You and I, you and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're beautiful like diamonds. Of sun rays, I saw the light inside so shine bright. Tonight, you and I, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I too, I, so alive, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky.
Once raised to the universe, we shine in recovery. Feel the warmth, never die. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. At first sight, I felt the energy of sun rays. I saw the light inside your eyes, so shine bright. Tonight, you and I, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I too, I, so alive, we're beautiful like diamonds in the sky.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
Oh,
shine bright like a diamond.
We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky. I too, I, so alive. We're beautiful like diamonds in the sky.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
Just real quick before we continue on, I know as I'm looking around the room, you know, these guys are up here putting on a great presentation. They're doing a good job. It takes a lot of courage for them to get up here. please pay attention to them. Don't be talking to each other and stuff like that. It's just, it's rude, okay? So pay attention to what's going on up here. I appreciate it.
Margaret, wait.
Go Parker. Because these were super fabulous. But this song is going to be coming up in a minute. And Chris, if you go ahead and put the video up on the screen too. And then I have a great video. And I want to have you listen to this song that we're going to have coming up here momentarily. And I really want you to close your eyes. And I want you to hear the words to this song. Because it is a song that can set you free. So I want you to really pay attention to it. And Chris is getting this all geared up here.
I had searched for life's meaning, enslaved by this world and my greed, and then the door of my prison. The past.
Texas. That picture was taken by my very own brother-in-law in his backyard in Genesee. And he thinks there's four of them, but I thought it was like they were posing. You know, the little head underneath of the big one, and oh my gosh. The music, Free at Last, was sung by our very own Shay's uncle. Shay's uncle. Yeah, wow. The CD is absolutely magnificent. But I love the one, Free at Last, because we have all been in shackles, haven't we? We have, and we don't have to stay there, though, do we? Joyce Meyer is in Denver this week, the 11th, 12th, and 13th. For any of you who don't know her, you should get to know her. She's an awesome, awesome woman of the world, and she, I'm sure, is going to bring us Denver a great message. So the 11th, 12th, and 13th, probably in the evening, so you should all try to go out and see her. I am asking for a special prayer request this morning for one of our residents. His name is Phil. He has had some serious illness going on. He is in the hospital right now, and we are going to pray that God heals him because he needs a touch from the Lord. At Mary's Hope, if any of you, and you all know who you are, owe bed fees, you need to make special arrangements with me this coming week if you have not already done so. All right? Theodore Roosevelt said this, "Wisdom is 9/10 a matter of being wise in time. Most of us are wise after the event." I love the old story about the fox, the wolf, and the bear who went hunting together. They each caught a deer, and they began to discuss how they were going to divide the spoils. And the wolf said, "Well, I think that we should divide the spoils evenly." And at that, the bear suddenly ate the wolf. The bear then turned to the fox and asked, "How do you think that we should divide the spoils?" And the fox said, "Well, I think that you should have the wolf's deer, and I would like to offer you my deer as well." And the bear asked the fox, "Well, where did you get such wisdom?" To which the fox replied, "From the wolf." You all probably didn't get that, did you? Who got it? Shelley got it. Learning from the mistakes of others is one of the best ways to gain wisdom, but such learning only comes with a spirit of humility. Wisdom is typically birthed out of our own experiences, but if we can allow ourselves to gain wisdom from the adverse experiences of others, we actually save ourselves from unnecessary hurt and pain. In other words, you have to look at somebody else's problems and learn from them so that those don't come on you. God oftentimes permits us to see the mistakes and failures of others so that we can better safeguard our own lives. Doug Larson said, "Wisdom is the reward you get from a lifetime of listening when you would have preferred to talk." Those who are wise learn the value of keeping their eyes open and their mouths shut. Lesson learned. Ergo, the picture of the foxes. Be wise as a fox. Praise God, right? All right, so you're going to be glad that you're here. That's just an extra tidbit about the fox. I had to find something relating to a fox if I was going to show you that picture, and I needed all of you to see that picture because I thought it was awesome, fabulous. So that's outside of today's message. You're going to be glad that you are here today, because today is the day you are going to receive. So I am. Exodus 3:14, and God said to Moses, "I am that I am." And he said, "Thus shall you go and tell the children of Israel that I am has sent you to me." I wanted to see what I am meant. How many of you know what I am means? Nobody. Oh, two of you. Okay. Well, you know, I'm not the brightest crayon in the box, so I wanted to see, what does this mean, I am? So, guess what I did?
I am.
Who said that? Oh, you get an A plus. That is awesome. Yes, I Googled it. I wanted to know what I am means, but I also wanted to know what does it mean in the Greek. So I went there, and here's how it is spelled. E-I-M-I. That's a mouthful. E-I-M-I. It means is, am. It is present tense. It is timeless. It is used by Christ several times in the Bible by calling him the great I am. That includes his eternity, his self-existent life, as our life, our bread, our light. I am. And it goes back to God's only name. What is God's only name? Does anybody know?
Yahweh.
Who said that? Caleb is going to, he's going to, I'm going to have to pay him. I am going to give him money afterwards. That's too, oh, he's going to be all right. I'm going to sit on the front row more often. God's only name is Yahweh. It means the Lord. He who always was, is, and will be. Now listen to me. People with a past need to make their way to Jesus. God will give you a miracle when? Now. A miracle today. Now. We need to, listen to me, we need to invest in our own deliverance. Sometimes God needs to see that we are willing to move toward Him. He needs to see that we're willing to move toward Him. We need to invest in our own deliverance. Faith without works is dead. In other words, you can have great faith, but until you do something, he can do nothing. Until you do something, he can do nothing. You can have all the faith in the world, sit in front of your TV at your house, and have faith that you're going to get a job. But you're not going to get a job until you what?
Do
something. You were too late on that answer, Caleb. Pay attention. You have to do something. You can't expect that at some knock on your door is going to be an employer saying, oh, would you please come to work for me? No. You have to go and you need to do something. Faith without works is dead. We have all, every person in this room, has been given the same measure of faith. Each one of us. God gave us the same measure of faith. It's what we do with that faith that will cause our prayers to be answered. You know, I think that there's many, many times, and many of us in this very room, that believe that we do not know how to pray. We go, well, I don't know how to pray, and it's because we've been in the misconception that we need to pray like, you know, the Spirit, these and thous, oh Father, I come to thee, and we don't need to pray like that. And many of us believe that we can't pray. Many of us believe that we have to go to the priest, confess our sins, and the priest will then be able to, you know, intercede on our behalf and go to God. Well, that was the way it used to be in the old times. That's exactly what they had to do. They had to go to the high priest. The priest would offer up a sacrifice to God. And that was the only way they could get to Yahweh, God, is through the priest. But thank God Jesus came. And Jesus became the sacrifice for us. And he said, now you can go directly to the Father with your prayers, and he will answer you. In John it says, therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you have received it, and it will be yours. And when you stand to pray, if you hold anything against another, forgive it, so that your Father can also forgive you. We are able to have prayers answered today. We are able to go to the Father today. We are able to go to Him and expect a miracle today. Why? Because He is the great I Am. I am means today. We don't have to wait until tomorrow. We don't have to wait until next week. We don't have to wait until next year. We need to go and ask God to answer our prayers today. Why? He's the great I am. Today is our miracle of faith. Today I will get my needs met. Today I will get the job that I want. Today I will hear my answer. Today I will be set free. Just like the song said, my shackles are going to be removed today. Whatever is binding you up today, you can be set free. The word tells us to come boldly to the throne. It's how Jesus said, come boldly to the throne. Why did he have to tell us that? Because prior to him coming, we had to go to the priest. He said, therefore, let us come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Thank God, his mercies are new every single day. Now listen to me, I am passionate about this today because too many of us are wandering around out in the wilderness area wishing and hoping that things are going to be changed in our life when all we need to do is come boldly to the throne of grace. He hears you and he will answer you and he will do it today. I am very passionate about this. Listen, the enemy tried to change my destiny through a series of hurtful events in my life. I've told you before, my father molested me for like the first 13 or 14 years of my life. I had a sister that died way too young. She was 37 years old. She had hit her leg on a car door and got a blood clot in her leg, and it dislodged and traveled through her heart. 37. He stole my sister from me. I had a mother that stole my heart, and she stole my love. I had a mother that robbed me of a relationship with my rest of my family, my uncles. I had a brother that tried to steal my money and my career. I had a daughter that left the family and took away grandchildren. I had loss of grandparents, loss of parents, loss of a brother, loss of a sister. A family. Now, we were a family that once lived together. We were raised together. And that family now became my enemy. They were my enemies. They were fighting against me. I even had to hire an attorney to defend myself. I was so screwed up at a young age that I dabbled in all kinds of stuff. Now, I know some of you in this room have dabbled too. I dabbled in the occult. I dabbled with Satan. I dabbled with witchcraft. I dabbled with the Ouija board. I dabbled. I was in the spiritual realm, but I was looking in all of the wrong places, and I was in the spiritual realm so that I could feel better. I wanted something to make that pain go away. Now listen to me, this is important. When you get so engrossed, so wrapped up in the pain of your past, you're all wrapped up in the pain of your past, you will not be able to receive the rewards that God has for you when you're so wrapped up in it. You know, usually pain, now listen to me, I know what I'm talking about. Usually pain will not just fall off on its own. You're going to have to release it. And you may have to release it by faith. But you cannot stay engrossed and wrapped up in pain. Recognize that where life has seemed irrational, how many of you life has seemed irrational and out of control? That's where I was at. My life was irrational. It didn't make any sense. My life didn't make any sense. It was irrational. And then what happened when it was irrational is my life spiraled out of control. But you know what? He will turn it around. When trouble was breaking loose in my life, and I thought I couldn't take it anymore, the great I am was introduced to me, and he did like the song said. He broke every chain that held me back, and he will do the same for you today. We can't expect the world to stop. Now listen, we cannot expect the world to stop because we had a bad childhood. We cannot expect the world to stop because some traumatic event
happened in our life. We cannot expect the world to stop because your mother died or your father died. We can't. We have to continue living. We all have had great loss in this room, and we have to continue moving our life forward. We can't just let the thing stop. We have got to move it forward. We need to learn how to celebrate who we are in God. God to free us from the pain. He needs to separate us from the past and from our pain, and He will do it today. I was looking in all the wrong places. I was not going in the right direction. Satan tried to get my destiny off track. Until I was introduced to the great I Am. I could continue to nurse my wounds and you know, just lay up in my bed and curl up in my bed and go to sleep, but I knew that I couldn't do that. Now listen to me. This is not religion. It is not rituals. He is the truth. He is the truth. I knew that it was the truth when I got introduced to the great I Am. I knew it. I don't know how I knew it. I knew that I knew that I knew that that was the way. I knew He was the truth. And I quit dabbling in all of the wrong things. I Am came. He came and showed me that He was the way. He is the truth. And He began to change my life. And He put my life on a road where He can now fulfill the destiny that He has for me. I was trying to do it myself. He has a destiny for me, and once I let Him do it, now He can do it. We need to become people that believe in today. It is today is our day. Today is the day that He can set you free. This day. I have had so many people in the last couple of weeks come to me and tell me miracle stories about what God is doing in their life. I had a young man come in to me about 2 weeks ago, and he had just this hurt look on his face. And he said, he dressed up in a suit, and he said, and I went and applied for this job that I really wanted as a salesman in a car dealership. And he said, I went through the whole interviewing process. I felt really good about it, and I really thought that I was going to get the job. And then they told me that they would not hire me because I have a felony. Because I have a felony. He was heartbroken. He was absolutely like somebody ripped his heart out. He was just distraught and heartbroken. And then last week he comes into my office and he says, Mary, guess what? And I said, what? He said, I went to another dealership and I got the job. Now, miracles happen. Now, he could have gotten all depressed and said, the guy said, well, you're not good enough to work here because you have a felony. And then he could have gotten discouraged and never gone and applied again for a salesman position. That's what he could have done. But instead, he kept going and he tried again. And today, he is hired with the job that he wanted. Don't tell me that miracles don't happen every single day to every single person in this room. God is answering prayers instantly today because our time is short. He, you know what He's doing? He's causing Amos 13 to come to life right before our eyes. Caleb, what does Amos 13 say?
I have no idea.
Have you ever read anything in Amos?
The wood plane.
Do you know that it is in the Bible? Okay. Well, nobody else knows that there is really a chapter called Amos. So let me read this to you now. Pay attention. It says, "Behold, days are coming, declares the Lord, when the plowman will overtake the reaper. The plowman shall overtake the reaper. He who breaks up the ground and prepares it for seed shall be ready to tread on the heels of the reaper, who shall have a harvest so large that before he can gather it all in, it shall be time to plow the ground again." Now, who can tell me what that means? Caleb's going, I don't have a clue what that means. Nobody can tell me what that means. Here's what it means. This is happening today. It means that by the time your prayer requests go out of your mouth, your answer is coming instantly. In the old days, a plowman would make straight rows. They would plow the ground. How many knows that? Are y'all with me? They plowed the ground. So they would plow the ground and make a row, and then they would plant what in it?
Seeds.
You are with me. You're doing good so far. And then they would water the seed, and the seed would take, it wouldn't grow instantly, would it? It takes time for the seed to, let's say they're planting corn. It would take time for the corn to pop up, right?
Right.
But he is saying this, behold, days are coming when by the time you put the seed in the ground, it is sprouting up so quickly that it's time to plow again because it's so much, it just comes up instantly. And you're going to have such a great harvest when it does. Same thing today. This is happening today. Pray, 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 pray. You need to be praying right now today. Pray, and he will answer that, and he's going to give you an abundance when you do. Whatever your prayer request, it says, ask and you shall receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be open. It's going to happen instantly today because Amos 13 is coming to fulfillment as we speak today. Today is your day for overflow. Aren't you glad you came today?
Yes.
Now, for the roommates that you know didn't come today, you need to pass it on to them. We'll give them a break because they're not here. Or you can keep it a secret, whichever you want to do. They need to be punished because they're not here today, right? So now, last week we announced that Chris has dedicated his morning to prayer. Every day, 11:15, he is asked and invited people to come, and he prays with them. And so the first 3-4 days, people were coming. And then the last couple of days, nobody came. And, you know, it's funny because faith without works is dead. I had one man come to me and he said, you know what, Mary? I went and I prayed with Chris and he said, no lie. I could actually feel the Holy Spirit coming through him. And my prayer was immediately answered. You know, Chris is a prayer warrior. He knows how to pray. He can get prayers answered, but you can too. He has been anointed with prayer, but you've been anointed with prayer too. So, but sometimes we need to hook up, don't we? Sometimes we can't do everything all by ourselves. We need to hook up a little bit. And so I'm asking you to hook up with somebody. If you can't make it to hook up with Chris, then hook up with somebody. Now, in this day and age, you should be texting your prayer requests, emailing your prayer requests, calling them in, writing them down while you're in here, and we'll pray over them all week long. But you've got to do something. When you make a special effort to come and pray, God will hear and honor you for doing that right thing. He will come and he will honor you for being there. Faith without works is dead. He is the great I am. He's trying to convey a strong message to you today. I am will meet you right where you are right now today. I am is looking for you today to say, I will. I am. I will. I will reach out. I will pray. I will ask. I will spend time with you, God. I want to know more about you. He's waiting expectantly for you to do something. He's saying, just do something so that I can work in your life today. He wants to work in your life today. He'll meet you right where you are today. You know, I looked this word I am up. I Googled it. And I also found that there are 7 references when Jesus was here about using the word I am. And these are important. Number 1, I am the bread of life. Now, I had to think about that. I had to pray about that. I am the bread of life. He is the bread, that means he is our nourishment for life. When we spend time with him and his word, he's going to nourish our souls and he's going to give us life. That's why you have to spend time with him. If you don't spend time with him, then it doesn't happen. I am the light of the world. There's too much darkness in the world today. Has anyone noticed the darkness in the world today? Because people have lost their way. Just as I had lost my way and I was searching in all of the wrong places. The great I Am is telling us that when we look to him, that he will be a lamp unto our feet and he will light up our life. Let him light up your life today. He also said, I am the door of the sheep. When a shepherd watches his sheep, even if one of them wanders off, I was one of his sheep and I didn't even know it. But I wandered off away from him. And he left all of the other sheep to come and get me. And he'll do the same thing for you. Because he is our door. The great I Am. He is your door. In Psalms 23, it talks about the good shepherd. And we need to know that he is a good shepherd. He will answer your prayers. He said, I am the good shepherd. The Lord is our shepherd, the good shepherd, that he will tend to us and he will take care of you. He wants to take care of every need that you have. Every need that you have. Have a bad hair day? Ask him. He'll help you do your hair. He will. He wants to be a part of everything in your life. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. He will resurrect you. He will resurrect your dead old life and he'll make it new. Ladies and gentlemen, he did that for me. I had a dead old dry life. I was dead. I was dead. I was dead. And he resurrected me. He not only found me, but he resurrected me, gave me a new life. He says, I am the way. I am the way. I am truth and I am life. The great I Am is the right way to go. He is the truth. And he will give you a new life. We got to stop believing lies. Stop dabbling on all this occultic junk. That is a lie. We need to come to the one who can really do some good work in us. And then he says, I am the true vine. What did we talk about last week, Caleb?
Vines.
Vines. You are paying attention. We talked about vines. He has not a clue what we talked about. He thinks, man, I got her fooled today. No, he has no clue what we talked about. Does anybody remember? Oh, one person, David. What did we talk about?
You have to be attached to the vine if you want to bear any fruit.
There you go. Why? Because the vine is the root.
Yeah, right.
We talked about bad roots, didn't we? That's right. Yeah. Cindy, you should know that. You came and told me. Wow, she said, that's great. You remember, didn't you? Just being shy, aren't you?
Yes.
All right. He said, I am the true vine. He is our root. He's our good root, and we are the branches. David said, we have to be attached to him. There are many areas in the Bible that teach us about the anointing oil. How many of you know about the anointing oil? Oh, one person, two people. Two? Going twice? Three? Maybe? Four? Man, I should have brought some money and we could have really given something away, huh? Oil in the Bible is very special. They would anoint you with oil. And when they anointed you with oil back then, they would pour the oil on you. We're not going to do that today, but I do want you to come. If you have need today, we're going to have Chris pray with you, and he's going to anoint you with oil. If you want just the anointing of God to be in your life today, come and ask, and Chris will anoint you, and he will have a blessing over your life. If you don't need prayer today, but somebody else does, or you want to pray for somebody else, that's always an uncanny thing, isn't it, that you would pray for somebody else, come and Chris will anoint you with oil, because He has been anointed. If you need delivered from spiritual darkness, you need to come. If you need healing in your body today, you need to come. If you need financial prosperity, you need to come. And he had me put this down for some reason, and I'm not sure why. But if you need your eyesight healed, you need to come. If you need set free from addiction, you need to come. You need to come. You need to come. Today's your day. I am means... He's never going to sit on the front row again. Today, I am right now. I am right now today. Don't go another day, ladies and gentlemen. Do it today. You can do it today. So I am going to ask for prayer requests for anybody who's not going to come and have Chris anoint them with oil. But I think that you should come. But anyway, yes, Rob.
I've got a good friend that lost a good friend of theirs. And the sad thing is the lady died from liver failure and kidney failure. And it's a shame to see the people that she was a drinker, of course, and they were celebrating, and I guess her life with alcohol. And I thought, do these people not see what killed her? And it's just, you know, it's just sad. So just, you know, pray for her and all the people that are blinded.
Thank you. Yeah, there's a lot of people that are blinded. Amber.
I'd like to say thank you. My brother was in the hospital last week. He's recovering well.
Awesome.
And so I wanted to
now thank that's Mary. A miracle.
I wanted to thank Mary because I was scared and he was in Montana alone. Me and my other sister made it there. And I think through the power of prayer and just our cousins being there really helped him. And he came, he's a lot better.
Now I have to just say, this beautiful lady right here, and by the way, you look absolutely gorgeous today. Not that you don't all the time, but you look unusually beautiful today. She called me in tears 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago. And she said, Mary, I've got to go to my brother tomorrow. He's dying. And they don't expect him to live. He has some weird infection. The doctors could not figure out what the infection was, nothing about it. And this young lady here was afraid she wouldn't make it home in time to say goodbye to her brother because the family thought he was dying. We prayed on the phone, and we believed God that he would be healed. And thank God he's being healed. Now that's a miracle. That's what God is. No, you thank God for that. Don't thank me. Awesome. That's great. That's great. So don't forget, we're going to pray for Philip today, though, okay? All right. Prayer request. Yes, Tim.
For my Aunt Gloria, we got cancer, and she's not going to take the radiation.
Your Aunt Gloria has cancer? Okay. Do you know what kind?
Lung cancer.
Oh, lung cancer. Okay. Is she here in Denver?
Yeah.
Okay. I have a doctor that she could go see. Come and see me.
She decided that she doesn't want to do radiation yet.
Yeah, he doesn't do that, though.
Okay.
Come and see me, and I'll tell it to you, and then you can decide, okay? Gretchen.
My daughter, Alexis, is sobriety.
Yes. Yeah.
I have a friend named Rocky, whose daughter is in her 20s, and she died from her suicide. She left you two young boys.
Okay. Is it that young lady? Yes. We will. You two match.
I noticed that too.
Oh, isn't that cute?
Yes. For my friend and her family for comfort, she lost her dad this week. So it was kind of an abrupt thing. And also my sister's kind of having a tough time.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Billy.
I want to give honor and praise to God for my past week's accomplishments. I really appreciate him in my life. Thank you.
Thank you. I tell you, you're something else, Billy. He can drive down the street and see a barbecue grill that they're trying to sell for $50. So what does he do? He stops, talks to the guy. He said, well, I'm part of an organization that runs sober homes, and man, they could sure use that barbecue grill. Would you mind donating it? 5 minutes later, they're putting it in the back of his truck. I mean, he's amazing.
Billy, I need a new car.
Yeah, if you need anything, go see Billy. Billy will get it for you. All right, anybody else? Yes.
I pray for my mom. She still hasn't found a job in 3 months, so now they're having to sell the house that we've lived in for 35 years.
Okay.
So it's kind of emotional.
What's her first name?
Linda.
Linda, okay. Heidi.
I just want to say thank you for your sermon this morning, because it is so very, very true. Like, I write down my prayers very often, and I use the words I am in those. I do exactly what you say. I speak it as though it is. And I can go back, even just from a couple months, and pull up things I've written, and they've manifested in my life.
Oh, no, that's a great thing to do.
Yeah.
Everybody should do that.
So,
very nice.
Thank you.
That's awesome. Stephen,
can you throw my hand to so sick to help you? And unfortunately, her dad passed away on Monday.
I'm so sorry to hear that.
For her to get through that and the healing.
Okay. Thank you. Last call. Dick.
So Mary, I know of a person that has been ordered by the courts to spend a short time in prison. And I just hope that they can get through that.
Thank you, Dick. Billy?
I'd like to ask for a prayer for the clients in this program.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Anything else? Yes.
Mary, on a lighter note, for those of you that like the comics,
yes.
You know what Popeye said?
No.
I am what I am.
Oh, that's perfect right there. That's a good way to remember that. Never to print. I am that I am. All right, anybody else before we stand and pray? And do come. Those that need extra special prayer, Hannah, come up and get anointed with oil, and your prayers will be answered, okay? All right, let's stand and pray. Yep. Would you mind, James?
Heavenly Father, we come before you in petition and in plea, Father God, for your strength and your mercy. Help us to rely upon your word. Help us to realize that we are and that we can do all things through you. Help us to overcome our weaknesses, our struggles, our pains, our ills, our acid, whatever it may. Heal us of whatever pains that may be brought before you, struggles, Father God, that you would redeem us from them. Because first it's been said that prayer can accomplish more than we can. So we lift up these things in prayer, Father God, knowing that you would do just as we request and we ask. Help us to be relieved of our heavy hearts, of our hurts, our ills. Help us to receive and to cherish that joy that you wish for us all. We ask for strength, we ask for unity, we ask for help, we ask for guidance, we ask for your mercy, we ask for your grace, we ask for all abundance, we ask for your healing power. We believe today, in this hour, as Mary said, that you would deliver in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, I gotta go.
Hey.